Hi, I'm Bob Plankers. I'm a senior technical marketing architect with VMware Corporation, and it's my pleasure to introduce Encrypted vMotion, a VMware vSphere feature that helps us protect our data in transit. To understand Encrypted vMotion, we need to understand a little bit about vMotion itself. If you want to understand more about vMotion, I'm not going to get into the gory details here, but if you want more information about vMotion itself, go out to core.vmware.com. We've got lots of information about everything having to do with vMotion. It's a really interesting technology. It was game-changing in 2006 when it was released, and it's a really important part of our data center strategy, outage avoidance, decoupling patches from infrastructure, from workloads, and that. Really important. But I digress here. For our purposes, we just really need to know that there's a source hypervisor, a destination hypervisor, and they communicate over the network. They open a network connection per VM, per vMotion, and use that to transmit the VM state, the memory, copy memory across, copy CPU registers, all that sort of thing, across to the destination host. So what's the difference between encrypted vMotion and regular vMotion? Well, there's almost no difference from a functional perspective, except that that network connection is now encrypted. Same, everything applies, same processes, all the features still work great. And so it's just in transit across the network, it's protected from snooping. vSphere 6.5 is where this feature first appeared. It's also in 6.7, 7.0, and it'll continue into the future. We have no immediate plans to remove it. So it's a very important part of our data protection strategy. You can turn it on a per VM basis. It's you can set it live, so a VM that is running can have this set, and it will take effect immediately. There are three different settings for it. Disabled, pretty straightforward, will not use encrypted vMotion if it's set to disabled. Required, it has to use it. And then there's this opportunistic option as well. Opportunistic is actually the default. We recommend setting it to required. Our security configuration guide, the hardening security advice that we give for vSphere and workloads, recommends setting it to required. But if you leave it as opportunistic, what will happen is it will encrypt a vMotion if both hosts, source and target, are running 6.5 or newer, and their CPUs support AES-NI instruction sets. Those are cryptographic instructions that really dramatically speed up processing cryptographic algorithms and doing cryptography. And so if that's true, then it will use it. If those things aren't true, then it won't. AES-NI was introduced about, you know, more than 10 years ago. The Intel Westmere EX platform and the AMD Bulldozer platform. And so chances are that your CPUs support it just fine. But if you want to check that, that's always you can always go to the VMware compatibility guide. Just Google for VMware compatibility guide, and that'll have information about what you need. What happens when you kick off an encrypted vMotion is that the vCenter server creates a one-time cryptographic key, a 256-bit cryptographic key, and then supplies that to the two hosts, the source and the target hosts. And then they use that to establish a connection. It becomes a shared secret for them. If the destination host is managed by a different vCenter server, then that key is shared with vCenter server, the other vCenter server, perhaps enhanced link mode, whatever, and then it's shared with the host from there. All of that is done via TLS. All connections, all management connections inside the cluster are protected with TLS. And so from there, the two hosts have that shared key, and then they can communicate. They use AES GCM as the encryption algorithm. It's FIPS validated, which is great for compliance, and it's fast. It's low overhead and fast. That's exactly what we want out of a vMotion connection. One key per vMotion. It's not reused. So if you kick off five migrations and they're all encrypted, you'll get five different keys on five different streams. They don't reuse them. It's per VM. It's not reused. It's not stored on disk. It's not stored anywhere. It's stored temporarily in memory and then removed from memory as best as we can. If you're really worried about that, you'll have to reboot the host to ensure that it's completely gone, but at least it's not accessible to an attacker or whatever. There's no relationship between vSAN encryption, VM encryption, and encrypted vMotion. And to that end, you don't need a KMS. You don't need a key provider like VM encryption and vSAN encryption do. They use a KMS to store their keys. But these keys, the encrypted vMotion keys, are completely ephemeral. They are only one time used one time. We don't store them, so we don't need anywhere to put them because we don't keep them around. This is also very scriptable. One of my favorite features of vSphere, the vSphere client in 6.7 and 7.0 now, is code capture. It's in the developer center, and you can record actions that you take inside of the vSphere client in order to, it'll turn it into a PowerCLI command, it'll turn it into a PowerCLI script, a JavaScript, Python, and compilable Go program even. And so that's a great way if you've got thousands of VMs and you want to audit this, that's a great way to do it. If you've got questions, we've got answers. We try to keep them to be a one-to-one relationship. Ask a question and get an answer. Instead of going through all of them here, I've written them all down. They're at core.vmware.com/encryptedvmotion. In fact, they're not quite there. There's a link to frequently asked questions. Go ahead and click that, and this QR code will take you to the main page for Encrypted vMotion. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being our customer. I hope you're staying safe and taking care.